Have you ever had trouble distinguishing a zebra from a cow? What kind of stupid question is that, you might wonder? Well, let me just warn you not to be surprised if you see a zebra. Or, well, a cow that looks very much like a zebra, as you pass by a field or a farm next time. I know this all must sound a bit strange, but it's all to do with these little guys right here. But what's actually going on? Why would zebra stripes reduce the amount of biting flies chowing down on a cow? Wanna know more? Stick around as we dive in on what this all means. Welcome back. Today we're discussing the wild phenomenon of painting cows with black and white stripes, like that of a zebra. Now let's get down to it. So, zebra cows. What on earth is that all about? Well, a group of Japanese scientists painted a bunch of cows black and white. For research and science, you know, of course. Why? Before we get to that, let's talk about zebras. These comical creatures have always been a favorite for their distinguished black and white themed bodies. But why do zebras have that striped skin? Biologists and scientists have mulled on this for ages, and have come up with more answers and possibilities than stripes on a zebra. According to Rudyard Kipling's Just So Stories, the zebra got its stripes from standing half in the shade and half out, with the slippery, slidey shadows of the trees falling on its body. But evolutionary scientists beg to differ. Among multiple plausibilities, three have been finalized as being the most likely reason for zebras to have evolved with the patterns they have. The first one is that of camouflage, or protection of predators. This is also the least supported hypothesis out of all three. The hiding in plain sight theory would have made more sense if zebras lived and grazed in forests in the shadows of trees. But they roam around on open grasslands in herds, very much on display for predators. The second idea is that the stripes help in thermoregulation, which is a fancy word for dealing with heat. The black stripes apparently help in absorbing heat in the morning, and the white stripes help in reflecting intense heat. But this doesn't seem entirely convincing either. The third theory is what we're interested in. Apparently, the black and white stripes help to ward off flies. Pests and flies are some of the biggest nuisance to grazing animals. Biting flies are attracted to odor, motion, color, brightness, and polarization. March flies and biting flies have huge eyes and vision, which is important for finding animals to bite and suck their blood, said Keith Bayless, a postdoctoral expert in fly biology. They're looking for big, dark, moving shapes. So how do patterns affect that? Evidence suggests that stripes confuse a fly's motion detection system. They end up approaching targets too fast. They can't decelerate as they should, thus becoming unable to land on the animal and instead bounce off. And so this is what brings us to painting cows. Different kinds of flies and mosquitoes are the biggest pests that affect the livestock. Biting flies negatively affects the quality of the cattle life. Apart from being potentially vectors of diseases, flies also affect the grazing habits of cattle. The presence of flies will cause cattle to move around, fidget, and disrupt their feeding, reducing the amount of nutrition they intake. In a nutshell, they'll be busy trying to swat away the flies instead of eating. Biting flies also tend to make the cows bunch together to reduce the risk of getting bitten. This again means distraction from proper feeding, as there'll be increased heat stress and also injuries. Generally, the feeding and bedding downtime is reduced, impeding proper growth. It affects weight gain and reduces milk production. Who would have thought that tiny flies would be this much of a factor in determining the supply growth of milk, right? In fact, experts say that there is an estimated $2 billion loss in dairy and beef industries because of biting flies and insects that prey on cattle. And it's always that money loss that makes people come up with the most ingenious or outrageous of ideas. Scientists who were tasked with finding a solution for this turned to evolutionary biology, that is, to zebras. Will the black and white striped skin offer any help against these pests? Getting back to the Japanese scientists, they came up with an experiment to determine whether the stripe theory had any truth in it. They included six black Japanese cows in their subject group and painted each cow in one of three ways. Black and white stripes to resemble a zebra, only black stripes, and the final three, which were the control group, no paint at all. Japanese cows are naturally black, just like the underskin of zebras, and so the painted black ones did not appear much different than normal. This was done to ensure that the smell of paint would not be what was distracting the flies. The researchers then closely observed the cows, watching each of the fly-repelling behavioral traits. These included ear flapping, twitching of the tails, skin flicks, stomping, etc. The flies were also photographed to note the number of flies present on each side. They also placed fly-catching sticky sheets to each group to determine the species of flies present. The results were actually impressive. The number of bite marks, as well as flies on the black and white striped painted ones, were significantly lesser than that of the other two groups, almost by half. There was virtually no difference in the data collection between the control group and the black painted groups, which ensured that it wasn't the paint odor that made a difference. Assessment of the results showed that the control cows carried out an average of 53 behaviors in 30 minutes, while the black striped cows carried out 54.4 in contrast. The black and white cows only carried out 39.8 behaviors in each 30-minute window. They concluded that this interesting development could potentially save the cattle industry billions of dollars and increase productivity. This wasn't the only zebra-inspired costume change experiment that was tried on specifically for the purpose of finding solutions for cumbersome pests. On a farm in Britain, domestic horses are kept alongside zebras in captivity. Did you know that zebras and horses are also cousins? Both belong to the Equidae family. The experiment involved 3 zebras and 9 horses of different colored coats of fur. They filmed and made observations and found that the number of horseflies that approached both species was almost the same numbers. But once at a close range, the flies seemed to be having trouble honing in on the zebras compared to the horses. The flies did get close, but tended to fly over or glance off the zebra. When it comes to horses, many more flies were able to stick that landing. Just like when you're flying on an airplane, a controlled landing is extremely important for flies. They don't want to break a leg or damage an eye, so when a fly comes in looking for a blood meal, they need to slow down. Somehow, stripes are preventing that from happening. Stripes have always been known to fool depth and spatial perceptions. This is why they've always been a hot topic when it comes to fashion. Speaking of fashion, let's move on to striped coats for horses. Yes, in this experiment in Britain, they didn't paint the stripes onto the horses. Instead, they dressed the horses in 3 kinds of cloth jackets. One white, one black, and one zebra stripes. Comparing results, it was found that fewer flies landed on the striped jacket than the plain black or white ones. But these fashion-forward jackets did not stop the flies from landing on the heads of the horses. And so, there was definitive conclusive evidence as to the usefulness of stripes on cattle. Now, back to our cows. The successful hypothesis gave the experiment the fuel it needed. As to the practicality of painting stripes on cows, the pros and cons of this idea, if you're concerned as to how the use of paint might affect the cows, those are well addressed. The cows are painted using animal-friendly and water-soluble paints, which are not harmful to the environment. The paint used in the experiment faded in just a few days. So no, your milk or your steak isn't going to have the negative effects of paint on them. The act of painting stripes on cows took about 5 minutes per cow, so the labor associated with it depends on the size of the farm and the number of employees. The alternative to this method is to use pesticides in order to ward off flies, which is highly detrimental to both the cattle as well as the environment. Not to mention that the fact that it aids in mutation of the flies to give rise to pesticide-resistant variation of flies, which is actually a pretty severe problem, not just among cattle, but also among humans. Drug-resistant bacteria is one of the biggest threats to health in the future. This is precipitated by the dairy and meat industry, which pumps an inordinate amount of drugs into cattle feed, which helps in a faster mutation of pathogens into drug-resistant varieties. Taking all this into consideration, this art project just might be worth it. Farms haven't yet begun to try out this paint job hack in larger experiments, but they might be willing to give it a try if they knew the true benefits of what seemingly sounds like a prank. Evolutionary traits hated by humans. See you next time.